In the given problem, we have Sx is the tangent to the circle at S, and Sx equal to Ox equal to Or given to us that Qx equal to 3 and PQ equal to 9. We have to find out what is the value of Os. So let's first try to find out what is the concept we have to use to solve this problem. Two concepts we are going to use, which are both from 9th or 10th class. One, that whenever there is a secant and there is a tangent to a circle, that from then we know that Sx square equal to Px into Qx, and that logic we can use to find out Sx. And the other concept what we use is the product of length of the segments of the chords inside a circular equal, that means PO into OQ equal to OR into OS. First let's try to find out Sx value, because we know Sx equal to Ox equal to OR, which will be useful to us. So first we'll write down what we know. We know PQ equal to 9 and we know QX equal to 3. So we'll write down QX equal to 3 and we know total PQ equal to 9. So then we have a theorem which says that whenever we have a tangent and a secant drawn from point X to the circle, then we have PX into QX is equal to Sx whole square. We know Px equal to PQ plus QX, which is equal to 9 plus 3, and multiply that with QX, which is equal to 3, is equal to Sx square. Or can we say Sx square equal to 36, or Sx equal to 6. Now once we know Sx equal to 6, we also know that Ox equal to 6. If Ox equal to 6, then OQ will be 3, because OQ plus QX equal to Ox. And we also know PQ equal to 9, that means PO plus OQ is 9, that means PO equal to 6. We also know that Ox is equal to OR, that means OR is also equal to 6. So we can write down OR equal to 6. Not only that, we know OQ equal to 3 and OP equal to 6. Now let's look at this product of the segments of the chords. We have OR into OS should be equal to OP into OQ. So can we go ahead and write down that? OR into OS is equal to OP into OQ. We have already enough information, so let's substitute. OP is 6 into OQ equal to 3 is equal to OR, but OR equal to 6 into OS, what we have to find out. 6 will cancel. We have OSC equal to 3 centimeter. So let's have a recap of this. What we have done? We have been given a circle in which Sx is a tangent. From X we have drawn one tangent and one secant to the circle. The concept we have used is whenever you have drawn a tangent and a secant from a point, external point to a circle, we have Sx square equal to Px into Qx. From that we found out Sx, but Sx is equal to Ox, which is equal to OR. That means we found out what is the value of OQ and OP and OR. Then we have that the product of segments of the chords are equal, therefore OR into OS equal to OP into OQ, which gives us OS equal to 3 centimeter. Let's move to the next problem. Now in the given figure, ABC is an equilateral triangle. Two circles of radii 4, 4 and 12 are inscribed in the triangle. What is the side of an equilateral triangle? Now we have a straight formula for this. Whenever we have an in circle, that means it touches all the three sides of the circle, we have the formula half into perimeter of the triangle into in radius, which is equal to 12 in this case. So equal to area of the triangle, equal to area of triangle. Let's substitute now. Half into P, we don't know the side, we have to find out, let us say X. Can I write down half into 3X into in radius 12 is equal to area of equilateral triangle is given by root 3 by 4 into x square. Let us simplify that. We get 18x equal to root 3 by 4 x square. We can cancel 1x. We have x equal to 72 by root 3, which is equal to 24 root 3. So in this particular problem, the inclusion of this small circle is only to divert us from the original problem. We don't need that. We just need this circle enough to find out the side of the equilateral triangle, because this is our in circle. And whenever we have in circle, we know that half into perimeter of the circle into n radius, because we can divide this circle into three parts and all the sides bases will add up to perimeter and all the altitudes will be equal to in radius. Is also equal to area of the triangle, in this case root 3 by 4 into side square. So let's move to the next problem. In the given figure, angle QRU is 72 degrees, angle TRS is 15 degrees and the angle PSR is 95 degrees. Then what is the value of angle PQR? Now we have been given lot of information, but we should be able to solve this problem in exactly 10 seconds. Once we realize that PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral and angle PSR is 95 degrees, and we know in cyclic quadrilateral the opposite angles are supplementary, so angle PQR equal to 85 degrees. The remaining information, whatever is given, supplements to this 85 degrees value. Even you consider QRU equal to 72, use alternate segment theorem and solve it, at the end you will be getting angle PQR equal to 85 degrees. So sometimes more than needed information is given just to divert us or just to make us feel uncomfortable with the problem. So how to solve it? Here, simple and straightforward, it's a cyclic quadrilateral, opposite angles are supplementary, so it will be equal to 85 degrees. So these are some problems which I just thought of sharing with you. I'll be doing more videos. I'll be catching you another time with some more interesting example. Till then, keep smiling and sharing. Have a wonderful day. Bye for now.